Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello guys, my name is Abdulrahman. And today, in this video, I want to tell you guys tutorial how to make crude website with Laravel. Okay, first, you must have one folder. This is special for all your Laravel project. So here, we'll make the folder for Laravel with terminal. Put in terminal. Then here, this type composer. Create project Laravel. And then this type here your what the name folder that you want. For example, here I make tutorial Laravel, and then the name of folder cannot be with the space, only can with strip or underscore. Just enter. Okay, this may take a long time, so here I will skip until the installing done. Okay, so here guys, the installing is done. As you can see here, a lot of package is installing. Then yeah, application key set successfully. Okay, so let's see here, the name of folder is tutorial Laravel. So here it is open, and then type here cmd. We will open this folder in Visual Studio Code space. Okay, this one is closed, and then yeah, okay, this. Okay, so here first we must make database. Okay guys, I will skip for creating database, and after I create database, after that I will show it again. Okay guys, so here I already make the database for this tutorial. You can see here, my database name is datasys1. Okay, from database, like previous, cannot give space, underscore, or strip. So here, we don't make a table, because table we will make in migration in Laravel. Here. Okay. First, we must connect from this file Laravel to database. Is open .env, and then here db underscore database. This change with your database name. Data. Oh, data is one.
Okay. Now.
Okay. And after this, we will make migration first.
We will need
this migration for table in here. So we make from terminal Skype PHP artisan make migration, then create, then for this part, for this part, for your table name, that table name must in plural, so add s at the end. For example, our database is sys1, so we make sys1, then table, enter. Okay, success. This this was able. Okay, so after that we will make models first. This model for connect field in database. So like previous PHP artisan make model, and here for model's name, and the first letter must be uppercase. Okay, already. Then that we make controller. Here controller. So controller for make the function that will generate our website. So here have artisan controller, and for controller name, the first is must like models, and then add controller. This what? Then C also uppercase. Okay, already. Okay, we close terminal. So after this, we make field for make table here in migration. Okay, here. This make table string, and here this for name of your, and here this for length. For example, this for name only 20 lah. Then we copy just 3. And here, for example, asal.
Here,
asal. And then we make 50. And here, make class. Maybe 20 also lah. Or 50. Oh, just make similar. Okay. After this, we should migrate this net field to database. So the way is PHP artisan migrate. Okay, done. We refresh here, then go to data siswa, then okay, already. And if we open siswa, okay, this our field, name, asal, and class. Okay, so we must add this field to this siswa. In models, so first we must protect it. Field label, then name, then asal, then class. It's must same right with the migration. So here I make class with uppercase, so here also we should make with uppercase. Okay, so here you add in the up on this sentence use, and then you see or go to see so controller should tap.
After that can
tap
artisan
tap, and then HTTP.
Okay,
then this is so controller, this so controller done. Oh, no. This go to models. So here,
yes,
models. Okay.
You got that.
Done. So first we will make the design or UI from our website first. You just go to resource, then views. Okay. We will make our design or UI from website in views. You just make new look. New file, and then example home. This our first page. Home, blade.php. Okay, yeah. Okay, and then don't forget also roots and what the package. This file for show the web, show the document that we make in Views. So if you want to show from code in this file, you should code first in web.php. Okay, make first and then here for the UI, I will use from this UI. This UI is the framework of Tailwind CSS. So here, you just type this UI. Okay, this. Then this one. Install this UI as Tailwind, and then use CDN. We will just use CDN or link. Okay, control C, and then just put here, and then for the script, we start, and then put here. Okay. First, we will make navbar first. Then you search here navbar. Okay, this, as you can see, there are a lot or code. Just type them out. Okay, this. We will just type this one, the blue one. Okay. Here. Okay. We make comment is for navbar, and then we change is for maybe tutorial Laravel, crude Laravel. Okay, if you want to see the result from this code, this project HP, and then welcome change to home. But we will make this the function we will make in Siswa controller. Then here we'll change. Okay. Then for see the result. Step here, have a artisan set. Okay, it's here. Here is the link. Then just click set. Control and click. Okay, so this is the result of our code. Sorry, result from this. Okay, we will make the code. So we will take the table from here. This is for put data. Just type table. Okay, here. And I will this table. Okay. Then copy. Then add comment here and then we start table. Data. Because all data in a database we'll put here. Okay. Maybe for row 2 until row 3 you can direct, because we just make one row from one table body, as we will use for each or looping. We just add no for number. Okay, so we will show the data from database here, use for each. The first, because in our database is there is no and data, just make new data. Insert. Okay, here, just type here, just for the name, for example, name, okay, from, then class is for okay. Here then go. Okay. See, let me see. Okay. We make our two data from this. Insert. This make manual. This is this for show in our website. Here. So first we go to web.php and then from the function and here just delete and then here this and then type controller. Okay, then double this class and this is for the name of function that we will make in controller. For simple, index. Okay, we make here. We make the function is public function. Then this the name of function. Okay. First, we make this. This is what? And then all. Okay. Okay, like this. And then after that, so turn view. And then here compact. And this is for name of the variable, but without color. Okay. remove this. This. Maybe. No.
How to use
that? How are we use? No. For each. Here we put the table here. Okay, so here it is for this what? For this the variable, then the item is this, we change or we convert from this variable to this. Simple, just S. Okay. So here we just change this S and then this. This is for name of it. Same. From here also. Okay. So let me see the. Let me see the result from this. Okay guys, here there is a bit error, so it changes here from this and then okay, we're ready. Let me see here. Okay. Why the table? But we already put the data from here to here, as you can see. So later we can fix this problem, but that's already okay. Let's continue. I guess we're already fixed the before. So here already like this. Okay. Yes. Now we just go to next. That is to add data. The script is create, read, update, and balance. So we just add new file here. Add blank.php. Okay. Here we will make for add data. Okay, like this. Then this delete this UI. Then this copy. Then put here. And also script. Okay. Okay. So also we must make nakbar. So I just copy and then put here. Okay. So here we'll search here that is input or text input. Okay, so this is for this for we type that is for add this. Okay, just like this. Just choose here, but I will delete the this and this. Okay. Send the command. Add data. Okay. So delete this one. And this one. Okay, this and then change this nah. So here make triggers because we have three fields. Okay, so here is for as well. This one is for class. And then here we make name is for nama. This is according to name field. Name song. And then name class. Okay. So we go to webpack mate and then my classes. But here is add. Then this is add also. Then we make the function here. Public function add. Then this is return view. Okay. So here we just like this. Okay, so this is the text input that we make in add that related to HP. Okay, I will make it ID first become to the middle. Okay guys, so here I already fixed the in text input. I replace it to the middle. So let's continue. So here for update we must have button here for add the data. So we go to this UI first and then we search button, this button. Okay, button. Okay, there are a lot of button. Just choose what do you want. Here I will use this button. Primary menu. Okay, this one the primary one. You just copy and then you put here. Okay, refresh. Oh, wrong. Up and then we put here. Refresh. Okay. Maybe we make this or button ya. This. And then button we move to here. Refresh. Okay. Then here we add margin top. Oh, let's see. Okay, already. So here the primary you just change with add because this for add data. Okay. So for that also. Here we must make form. So all of input here must in the form. So we make form first here. Okay. And then this we cut and then move to form. Okay. For action we just type this store because we will make the function in here for store for adding data and then here don't forget method then our method is post and then we just type here CSRF. Okay, and then for the button, type add, type submit. Okay, this already. And then we go to home first. Here, so we will make the button for adding data. Jadi we will put here. So like previous, tag button code from the UI, and then maybe here. Nah. Okay, let's see. Okay, already. Just make margin bottom. Four. Okay. And then we change this to add. Because this for add data. And then here we will change the button become A because this for go to add then her slash add. Okay, refresh. Then let's we try add and it will go to add page. Okay, this is a bit bug. Refresh first. Oh, because of form. And then become like this. And then so here we will make the function for adding data in here sysco controller, but previous before that we must make the route first, so just copy this and then copy this star. And then this the we will doing the function from start. Then the name of function is create, because we will create the data. So here public function create, then here we type request, then variable request. Okay. Then first is this what? This what? Now, read. Variable request. Okay. And then forgot something, and the request is this, and then oh, and then here this type return redirect, this is slash. So this is for the create data that is request in form this. Okay, and then after that when we press the button, so return the direct plus the website will go back to slash home, yeah, the place that for table. Okay, so let's try refresh first. Okay, already for example, yes. And then okay, and add. Okay, there is some trouble, error, so I will fix it first. Okay guys, here already successful, and then trouble before is in web.php the root for store it's supposed to must be post and not get, so it will work. Okay, let's try again. Then for example, okay, F. Okay, already this, and then if you see in database also, It's already successful. Okay. And then the first home we transfers
this
me and this become extra and this become plus and then as you can see here in website all is one and then we will make a for each paper number here okay then variable no is one okay and then here tap again and then variable no okay decrement increment then here we just type variable no then we refresh then okay become 1 2 3 4 okay guys and this also already changed so okay so next we will make edit or update so we will make one again for this name the sample name is action because here we will make a button for edit and delete okay seperti Calvin first and then just make like this and then here we use assign assign is for edit edit and then just copy and then here you change become error and here for edit and here on delete okay, let me see. Here. Okay, already. This for edit and this for delete. As you can see here, guys. Okay. So first, we make the previous make root first. Okay. And this become get. Okay, this root for edit. But because edit that is just only one data, so we will need ID. So from we will make here from ID. ID then slash edit then for the name of function is edit okay here oh in home first the button we change this button change to A and then make half is slash id slash edit like here guys here so here we make the function okay let's go okay guys before make the function I forgot to make the thing first. So here we make folder that is for update. because in edit, then we will update the data. So here, edit.blade.php. Okay. So we go to add, and then select all, and then copy, and then edit like this, because we will put here the edit and add the same, but we'll make just a bit different. Okay. Right here. No. Okay, so here we want to show edit first. Okay, this edit ID, and then here mark public function is edit. Yes, then edit. So here is ID, because we will go to the data that according to ID. Here in this slot, then this slot find ID. Okay, then here return view string is update dot edit, because file of edit is on the update folder. This, and then compact tag like this values. So because the edit, the UI or design same with add, but we will put the data from database here. So we use compact for putting the data. Okay, and then here this is wrong. Like this, and then variable s like this. Then and ID, then edit, and this edit that black with PHP. Okay, this already, and then in edit we will put the data from database. So here this type value and the name of field. So the name of field here. Okay, nama asalkan class nama, and then here value again. So nah, lalu down post. Okay, let's see query test first. Okay, sambil we want to edit this edit. Meeting, so this wrong list. This should be at nama, but this then variabel siswa. Oke, habis mergot, sorry. Sorry. Oke. Okay. Just refresh. Oke, okay, already. This for first one. Let's try for this. Data. The third one. Oke, okay, already. Oke, okay, it already like this. So we will make update. For update the from the old data to new data. So here we make first. Oh, here. So we will make update. Backslash. Here for ID. Method still post, and then here method put. Okay, this is for the name for method that we will put here. Okay, method put. So we make here we change the get or become put. And then this update ID. Okay, for the name of function is update. Here, we make the function public function update. Update here ID because we update the data according to ID, and then request. Okay, because we will add the new data, make the new data from or the change the old data become a new data. Okay. This one. Now. This fine. ID. And then. What update this that is request, then please return redirect to slash because after update or edit data we will after this control save because we want to edit that put press this button that will immediately go to slash or home, and then here okay. Okay, let's try business first, guys. Here my focus. Okay, should be like this. Is what I refresh. Already, so we want to edit this. Okay, save. Okay, already guys. Again, as you can see here. So, try again, very simple. This. Save. Okay, already guys. Okay. Edit this already. So the last one is what delete data. Delete. So for delete first here we make form. Yes. Because delete the where there is no file, so we make form here. So like before, update, then variable this one ID. Okay, like hello. Then method toss. So here first CSRF and then method usually for delete is destroy. Now and then the button remove here. Okay, so here we just make the root name is destroy update ID and here on the name of person spell it. So here public function select here ID right. This one find ID and then balok. So record saya direct slash this already. Okay, let's try. Refresh first. Okay, there is error. Remember the error. Root destroy delete. So here the so I will fix it first guys. Okay guys, so here I already fixed the error. So here I change the name of method is delete. So here also delete. And then here the previous is delete, so become destroy. Also here destroy. Okay, and then previously here I type variable siswa, that error also. So here we already convert each variable siswa as that we convert what is the content of variable siswa we convert become variable s. So here must be variable s. Okay, so let me try for delete. Okay, already guys. We delete again. Then okay, the data is disappeared. Also in database, if we refresh in database, okay. So maybe that's all from me guys for the tutorial. Thank you very much for watching. I hope this video useful for you guys. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.